great are you, Lord. God, where would we be without you? We're so thankful to be here in this studio. We wish you were here with us, but we know God is going to meet you wherever you are watching this. He promises to meet us right where we're at. I want to start today just by sharing a flashback memory I had as I was praying for this message and this time today. And it was a college memory when I was in an auditorium as a freshman. I was in a chemistry class. It was 9 a.m. It was about 300 people. I was 10 rows up from the professor. And because it was so early, I started dozing off as he was teaching, and he called me out. He said, "Mr. Schaefer, what do you think of that?" I have no idea how he even knew my name, but that was the last time I let that happen. And I don't want to be caught dozing off right now. The reason I tell you that is I feel like this is a moment God is getting our attention. And he's telling us to listen to the cries of people around this nation, around this world. It's time to look at the brokenness deeply in us and around us. And we need to see it. We need to recognize it. We need to understand it so we can actually do something about it. And so we have decided not to have a normal sermon today, but to have a conversation. DJ and I, in a few minutes, we're going to have a family conversation with some core family members at Ocean Hills. And although they're all black, they are not speaking for all black people everywhere. They're speaking just from their heart. They're speaking from their perspective, just as brothers in Christ. They're going to sit down and we're just going to talk about reconciliation and racial justice. And I have to admit, it's uncomfortable for me. It's not comfortable to talk about. I'm afraid I'm going to offend or be naive or say something wrong. I know I have not entered this conversation deep enough yet, and I have not entered this conversation soon enough, and so I grieve that, and I'm sorry for that. Even as one of your pastors and leaders, I'm sorry for that, and I'm going to do better, and I know that God is teaching me through this, and I am just leaning in and learning so much right now. So I want you to have that posture with me. Can we just lean in and have a listening and learning posture today? We have one verse that I want to share, two thoughts, and then we're going to get to this conversation. And the verse is Colossians 3:10. We're just going through Colossians 3 verse by verse. And listen to this verse, Colossians 3:10. Put on the new self and be renewed as you learn about God and become like him. Put on your new self and be renewed as you learn about God and become like him. God wants to renew us. Is anybody else tired? Anybody fatigued out there? Just raise your hand or raise your hand on your chat, wherever you're watching this. I think we're all fatigued. We all need some renewal. This is what God does. God renews us. He renews our spirit. And he is making all things new. He is making us new again. I know I need a renewal of hope in my life. I need a renewal of vision, a renewal of purpose, a renewal of my spirit, a renewal of my love for my brothers and sisters who think differently and who look differently than me. I need a renewal of justice and what God thinks about justice. God wants to renew our spirits today as we trust him. That's what this verse says, that as we trust him, as we put on our new self, as we put to death the old self, we put to death hate and anger and malice and rage. And Paul could have easily included racism and discrimination. We put those things off and we put on the new self of peace and reconciliation and compassion and love. That is when our spirit is renewed, as we cooperate and respond to what Jesus is doing in us. So God wants to renew us. Second, he wants to recreate us. God wants to recreate us. God's plan is to make us like Jesus, that we would become like him. Did you see that in the scripture? Become like him. He's gonna, it's not just a little makeover or a self-improvement plan. This is a complete spiritual makeover. He wants to put a new heart in us, a heart of tender love towards others. He wants to give us new eyes where we can see others as he sees them. He wants to give us new ears where we could hear the cries and the suffering of other people and respond to them. This is what God does. He wants to recreate us to become like him. I love what Saint Thomas of Aquinas said. He said, love follows knowledge. Love follows knowledge. Think about that. As we get to know God, as we learn about God, we learn about him. We begin to love him. We learn about his heart and his goodness and his faithfulness and his grace and his forgiveness. We love him more and more. And we become what we love, don't we? If I love money, I'm going to become greedy. If I love food, I might become fat. We become what we love. And so when we love God, we become more loving. We become more loving people. And that's what this world needs right now, is people who are transformed, people who are loving. That is what discipleship is about. It's about becoming like God and having God renew us and recreate us. So I hope this encourages you. I want to close just before we get to our conversation with a quote by Pete Scazzaro. He says this, I do not believe we can grow into spiritually and emotionally mature disciples if we do not address the effects of racism and prejudice in and around us. We want to grow into spiritually and emotionally mature disciples. And so we are tackling this. It can feel awkward. You might be tired of it, but we feel like it's so important, and God wants to speak to us through it. So I hope you enjoy this conversation as we listen to our friends, as we listen to perspectives and stories, we begin to love people in a new way. Listening leads to loving people. So enjoy this conversation.